Hello everyone and thanks for watching Edupedia World videos. I am Manish Agrawal and in today's session of mole concept we'll study limiting reagent and the calculations related to it. Okay, so this is going to be a very important topic because all the chemical reactions usually that come into your questions will have a limiting reagent in them. Okay, so let's see what a limiting reagent is. Well, let's say you have a reaction. Okay, we have studied various chemical reactions now. In the last session, we assumed all of the chemical reactions to go to completion. Okay, but for going to completion, it is required that the amount of reactants that you have are in specific quantities. Alright, what do I mean by that? Let's see. Say you have nitrogen and hydrogen, which are going to use to make ammonia. So now we know that 1 mole of nitrogen requires 3 mole of hydrogen. Alright, from the stoichiometric coefficient, this is a balanced equation. So we know that ratio here is 1:3:2. So 1 mole of nitrogen will require 3 moles of hydrogen for complete reaction. And when this reaction completes, it will form 2 moles of ammonia. Similarly, if instead of 1 mole, I have 2 moles of nitrogen, then I will need 6 mole of hydrogen. And when this 2 mole of nitrogen and 6 mole of hydrogen combine together, they will form now 4 moles of ammonia. Okay, so this is what we studied in the last session. Alright, at the time of stoichiometric analysis, we covered this. But what happens if instead of 6 moles, you have only 5 moles of hydrogen with you? Alright, so you have 2 moles of nitrogen, but instead of 6, now you only have 5 moles of hydrogen with you. So what happens then? Okay, it is quite possible, this scenario is quite possible, in fact, because you don't always have infinite amount of resources. Okay, you bought nitrogen, but now your pocket money is over. Okay, you spent all of your pocket money, so you don't have enough to buy the hydrogen. Okay, but you were able to procure 5 moles of hydrogen by the leftover money, and now you don't have even a penny left. So what are you going to do now? Okay, well, basically you cannot do anything. You needed 6 moles of hydrogen, you only have 5 moles of hydrogen, so your reaction will go on as long as there is hydrogen left with you. Okay, so I have hydrogen 5 moles. I needed 6 moles. Alright. So, all of this 5 mole of hydrogen is going to be consumed. Okay. Because it is less than 6. So, if I had 6 moles of hydrogen, I knew that all of that 6 mole will react with 2 moles of nitrogen. And ultimately, this nitrogen that was going to be left at the end of the reaction was to be 0. Similarly, the hydrogen that was to be left at the end was 0. So from 2 to 0, from 6 to 0. So all of 6 moles were going to be consumed. But now I only have 5 moles. So obviously all of these 5 moles will get consumed. Problem is with nitrogen. Alright. The nitrogen only gets consumed when I have hydrogen with me. Now I do not have enough hydrogen after 5 moles. Okay, after 5 moles, nitrogen is unable to find any more hydrogen atoms. Okay, it roams around in your container in which you are carrying out the experiment. It goes to each and every corner of your container, but it is still unable to find out any atom of hydrogen left. So what is it going to do? It cannot do anything. It is just going to stay there. Okay, it will remain unreacted. Okay, so basically now instead of 0, the nitrogen which will be left with you will not be 0. It will be something more than 0. Okay. Hydrogen left with you will be 0. Alright. Hydrogen left with you will be 0. But nitrogen will be greater than 0. Because it does not have any more hydrogen left to react. So it cannot react completely. Alright. So if it cannot react. Well, if it cannot react, then it will be left over. Alright. We get that idea. So let's see what happens now. Okay, so this is left with me. Alright, this is completely consumed, and obviously whatever hydrogen was consumed with nitrogen, that amount of hydrogen would have formed ammonia. So even ammonia will be greater than zero. Alright, but even if you look at ammonia, okay, let's say moles of nitrogen left is n. So here n will be less than 2 but greater than 0. Similarly, let's say if moles of ammonia is n, then here n will be greater than 0 but less than 4. Alright, here again n will be greater than 0 but less than 4. That is to say that all of your hydrogen is consumed, okay, all of your hydrogen is consumed but not all of your nitrogen is consumed. And as far as ammonia is concerned, we were unable to form 4 moles of ammonia because formation of 4 moles of ammonia required 6 moles of hydrogen, but I only had 5 moles. So instead of 4, the amount of ammonia that will be formed will be less than 4. Okay, so you get an idea what I am trying to say here. So this is how our final composition of the container is going to look. Okay, initially the container has this had these amounts. Okay, 0 mole ammonia, 5 mole hydrogen and 2 moles nitrogen. But finally, nitrogen will be somewhere between 2 and 0, hydrogen will be 0 and ammonia will be somewhere between 4 and 0. Okay, so these are the moles. What happened here? See, the hydrogen got over, so nitrogen could not react. So hydrogen limited the amount of nitrogen which could react. Okay, at the same time, since hydrogen got over, okay, since hydrogen was finished, ammonia could not be formed any further. Formation of ammonia requires hydrogen. So hydrogen also limited the formation of ammonia. Okay, so being in lesser quantity than required, okay, being in lesser quantity than required, what did hydrogen do? It limited both consumption of nitrogen and formation of ammonia. So here hydrogen is what? It is the limiting reagent. Okay, reagent is nothing but a substance used in your reaction. Okay, any substance used in your reaction, you can call it reagent. So hydrogen here is the limiting reagent. It limits the extent of your reaction. Okay, it ensured that ammonia was not formed enough, that is 4 moles. Ammonia formed was less than 4 moles, and it also ensured that nitrogen consumed was less than 2 moles. Why? Because you didn't take in enough amount of hydrogen. Alright, it's like you have physics, chemistry and maths that you need to study. Okay, but you studied less of chemistry. While you studied more of physics and maths, but you studied quite less of chemistry. So even if you do very well in physics and maths, your overall performance gets affected. It gets limited. Why? Because you studied only a limited quantity of chemistry. Okay, so your chemistry has put a limitation to your performance, has put a limitation to your result. Similarly here, hydrogen has put a limitation to the reaction. Hence it is the limiting reagent. Okay, so when we do not have enough quantities of all the reactants, what happens? The reaction ends up with excess reactants. Okay, excess reactants. Excess reactant means a reactant which is left over in the container. Alright, here nitrogen has been left over. Okay, the final quantity of nitrogen is not zero, it is greater than zero. So nitrogen here is the excess reagent. Okay, it is the reactant which is in excess, so it is the excess reagent. Alright, so once we understand this, okay, we can learn to identify a limiting reagent in any given reaction. Okay, please note here that in our question we only have two reactants in this one. Okay, in this particular reaction we only have two reactants. It might be that you have five different reactants. Okay, we might have five different reactants. Okay, and you will have to identify, you will need to learn how to identify which of those five are limiting reagents and which of those five are going to be in excess. All right, and why we need to study that, that is also something we'll cover in today's lecture. Okay, so first let's learn how to identify limiting reagent. Let's take up another example. H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid, reacts with NaOH. NaOH is a base, sodium hydroxide base. Okay, so sulfuric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide to form sodium sulfate. The salt here is sodium sulfate plus water. Alright, this is a simple basic acid base reaction. Okay, sorry, this is a simple acid base reaction. So you have an acid, reacting with a base to form salt and water. Okay, the reaction is already balanced. Okay, so the reaction is already balanced. Here stoichiometric coefficient is 1, here it is 2, here it is 1, and here it is 2 again. Alright, you have to ensure that reaction is always balanced. Okay, the concept of limiting reagent requires you to balance a chemical reaction. Okay, but we are already quite familiar with balancing. So let's move on to the next step, identifying the limiting reagent. So let's say I had 2 moles of H2SO4 with me. Okay, let's say I had 2 moles of H2SO4 with me and 3 moles of NaOH. Okay, now I need to identify which of these reactants is going to be the limiting reagent and which of these reactants is going to be in excess. So first thing that you need to remember here is the initial moles. Okay, these are the initial moles 2 and 3. Okay, the initial moles do not directly determine the limiting reagent. Alright, if you look at initial moles, 2 is for H2SO4 and 3 moles is of NaOH. So 2 is less than 3. This doesn't mean that H2SO4 is going to be your limiting reagent. Okay, the limiting reagent is the reagent which is present in less than the required quantity. Okay, this is the best definition of limiting reagent that you can have. It is the reagent taking part in the reaction which is present in less than the required quantity. Okay, so let's see here. 1 mole of H2SO4, if I look at stoichiometric ratios, 1 is to 2 is to, okay, that there are only 2 reactants, so 1 is to 2, this is the stoichiometric ratio, 1 is to 2. So 1 mole of H2SO4 required 2 moles of NaOH. Okay, so 2 mole of H2SO4 will require, okay, this implies 2 moles of H2SO4 will require 4 moles of NaOH, okay, twice the quantity. Okay, hence NaOH is present in less than the required quantity. 3 is less than 4, the required quantity is 4, but it is present only in quantity of 3 moles. Hence NaOH is going to be our limiting reagent here. Okay, so how do we calculate, how do we estimate limiting reagent? Or either you can use this method which I just showed to you, okay, using stoichiometric coefficient, or you can just remember from our last session, if you recall, okay, that we wrote, let's write it here, N1 by A is equal to N2 by B is equal to N3 by C is equal to N4 by D, and so on. Alright, from our last session, if you recall, that we studied this relation for a balanced chemical reaction going to completion. Okay, that is in which all of the reactants are consumed to form products. So we studied that moles of reactant 1 divided by its corresponding stoichiometric coefficient will always be equal to moles of reactant 2 divided by its corresponding stoichiometric coefficient, and so on for each and every reactant and product present in the reaction. Right. But what if the reaction is not going to be completed? What I mean is, what if one of the reactant is present in limited quantity? Well, in that case, this relation is not valid. Okay, this relation is not directly valid. Okay, it is still applicable, and how we'll study that later. But right now, at this moment, I cannot say that moles of H2SO4, which is 2, divided by its stoichiometric coefficient, which is 1. Okay, and similarly moles of NOH which is present with me is 3. Alright, the moles of NOH present with me is 3 divided by its stoichiometric coefficient 2. So 3 divided by 2 is 1.5. 2 divided by 1 is 1. So you can clearly see that in this case N1 by A is not equal to N2 by B. Why is that? This is because the reaction is not going to completion here. Okay, that is the 2 moles of H2SO4 are not going to be completely consumed. Alright, NaOH is going to be completely consumed. 3 moles of NaOH are going to be completely consumed, but 2 moles of H2SO4 are not going to be consumed. Hence, here this relation does not hold. And exactly this is the part which is going to help us to identify the limiting reagent. Okay, if you see here, we know that NaOH is the limiting reagent. Okay, at the same time, if you study these values, 2 and 3 by 2, which is less? 3 by 2 is less than 2. Okay, 3 by 2 is 1.5, it is less than 2. Okay, so you see that the quantity, the reactant which has this ratio in lesser quantity is going to be your limiting reagent. Alright, the reagent which has this ratio N1 by A or N2 by B in lesser quantity is going to be your limiting reagent. Let's see again. Okay, let's see this again. Let's say now I have 3 moles of H2SO4. Okay, let's say I have 3 moles of H2SO4. Okay, and NaOH, let's say I have 7 moles of NaOH with me. Now if I need to identify which is going to be the limiting reagent, what do I do? Just follow these steps that I am telling you. First, balance the chemical reaction. Okay, first step is to balance the chemical reaction. So upon balancing, I know that stoichiometric coefficient of H2SO4 is going to be 1 and that of NaOH is going to be 2. Alright, so this is the first step. I have completed the first step. Second step is going to be to calculate this ratio. Okay, moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient. So this was the first step. Okay, balancing of the equation. Okay, the second step is going to be calculate ratio. What ratio? This N1 by A, N2 by B, N3 by C and so on, depending on how many reactants you have in your reaction. Okay, so this ratio is nothing but moles, number of moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, stoichiometric coefficient. So you have to calculate this ratio, number of moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient. What is this ratio for NaOH? 7 moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient, which is 2. Alright, similarly for H2SO4, this is going to be 3 moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient 1. Right, so this is my second step to calculate the ratio of moles that to stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, third step, okay, third and final step is to identify which is less, okay, lesser value of ratio. Okay, of all the ratios that you have calculated, you have to identify the one with lesser value. Here 7 by 2 is, okay, 7 by 2 is 3.5 and 3 by 1 is 3. So which ratio is lower? 3? 3 is less than 3.5. So numerically in magnitude, the ratio for H2SO4 is less than the ratio for NaOH. Okay, once you have done that, you have your answer. The reagent with lesser ratio value is your limiting reagent. Let's say LR. Okay, let's say LR. So here H2SO4 is going to be our limiting reagent, while NaOH is going to be present in excess. Okay, so this is how you estimate the limiting reagent, the one which has lower value of the ratio. Which ratio? Given moles, okay, given moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, given moles is the moles which have been given to you initially in the container at t is equal to 0 seconds. Okay, when you are just starting with your experiment, so at that time the moles given to you of each of the reactant divided by their stoichiometric coefficient. And how did we arrive at the stoichiometric coefficient? By balancing of the reaction. So if you just follow these three steps, you can always estimate which is going to be your limiting reagent in the reaction. Right? It's pretty simple. You don't have to go into any other details or any other method. Okay? So once we have covered this, let's take another example for identifying limiting reagent. Okay. Let's see. Say you have this example, A2 plus B3 gives A2B3. Okay, it's a hypothetical reaction and we want to estimate which is the limiting reagent. Okay, given that you have 2 moles of A and 6 moles of B with you. Okay, so they have given us the initial quantities of each reactant and they have asked us to identify which of them is the limiting reagent and which of them is in excess. Right, first thing that you need to note here is you have 2 moles of A. Okay, you have 2 moles of A, you do not have moles of A2. Alright, you do not have moles of A2. So 2 moles of A implies, okay, 2 moles of A implies 1 mole of A2. Right, it's quite simple, quite clear. Okay, A2 is the molecule, A is the atom. You can clearly see that one molecule of A has 2 atoms. Okay, so 2 mole atoms of A will only give you 1 mole molecule of A2. Alright, so you actually have only 1 mole of reactant 1, that is A2. Similarly, 6 mole of B. Similarly, 6 mole of B implies how many moles of B3? It implies 2 moles of B3. Again, it's quite simple. You can see that B3 is the molecule and B is the atom. So 3 atoms of B come together to form 1 molecule. Okay, 3 atoms of B come together to form 1 single molecule. So 6 atoms, okay, will come together to form 2 molecules. Or 6 mole atoms will come together to form 2 mole atoms of B3. Alright, so now we know the quantities, the initial moles, that is the given moles of each of the reactant. Okay, I have 1 mole of reactant 1 and 2 moles of reactant 2. Alright, so I have values of N, that is initial moles. Okay, now what do I have to do? I have to just follow the steps, okay, the three steps in order to identify my limiting reagent. The first step of which was to balance the chemical reaction. Let's see if this chemical reaction is balanced or unbalanced. On the left hand side, I have A2, 2 atoms of A. On the right, again, I have A2. So A is balanced. On the left, I have 3 atoms of B. Again, on the right, I have 3 atoms of B. So luckily, even B is balanced. Hence, this chemical reaction is already balanced. Alright, so that solves our first step. Okay, so first step done, the reaction is balanced. Second step is to calculate the ratio of given moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient. We have calculated given moles. Okay, we have calculated given moles of molecules from given moles of atoms. So divide them by stoichiometric coefficient. 1 mole of A, okay, that is N by A and N by B. So 1 mole of A divided by stoichiometric, 1 mole of A2, sorry, 1 mole of A2 divided by stoichiometric coefficient of A2 is 1, okay. And for B, 2 moles of B3 divided by stoichiometric coefficient of B3 which is again 1, so 2 by 1. So this was my second step to calculate the ratio of moles divided by stoichiometric coefficient. My third step, okay, third and final step is to see which of this ratio is less. So 1 by 1 is 1, 2 by 1 is 2. So 1 is less than 2. Alright, 1 is less than 2. So the quantity 1 is less than 2 implies that A2 is going to be my limiting reagent. Alright, this is going to be my limiting reagent. Alright, so in this question, A2 becomes the limiting reagent and B3, the reactant B3 is in excess. Right, so this is how we identify the limiting reagent. Okay. Let's see further. Why is it important to estimate the limiting reagent? Okay. Well, you see, limiting reagent is going to be the most crucial part of your reaction. Okay, it's like, you know, the substance which is present in less quantity is always most valuable. Okay, for example, once upon a time, aluminium was quite rare until a scientist found a way to extract aluminium from dirt or common soil. Alright, so aluminium used to be quite rare, and at that time it was a lot more valuable, okay, even more valuable than gold. Alright, but now since we have abundance of aluminium, okay, the aluminium is now present in a lot more quantity than gold or silver, okay, or platinum or diamond, and hence value of aluminium has deteriorated. Similarly, the substance which is present in less quantity is our limiting reagent, and hence its value is a lot more. Okay, it's going to act as the linchpin of our reaction. Okay, linchpin means a most crucial part. Okay, it is going to be the determining factor of our reaction. Okay. How? Let's see how is it going to be the determining factor in our reaction. See, let's take up the first example again. N2 plus 3H2 gives twice of ammonia. Okay, again you have 2 moles of nitrogen initially, but only 5 moles of hydrogen. Okay, now we know how to estimate the limiting reagent. How do we do that? First, see if you have the initial moles. We already have the initial moles, 2 and 5 of reactants. Okay, second part, to see if the reaction is balanced, 1N2 plus 3H2 gives twice ammonia. Nitrogen on the left, N2, that is 2 atoms, on the right 2 atoms. Hydrogen on the left, 3 into 2, 6 atoms, on the right 2 into 3, 6 atoms. So hydrogen is also balanced. So this is a balanced chemical reaction. Hence, we don't have to balance it. So that solves our second step as well. Okay, it is balanced. Third step, okay, or next step is to calculate the ratio 2 divided by stoichiometric coefficient 1 and 5 divided by stoichiometric coefficient 3. Okay, which is less? 2 by 1 is 2, 5 by 3 is 1 point something. Okay, 5 by 3 is going to be 1 point something. So that is obviously less than 2. Hence 5 by 3, that is hydrogen, is going to be our limiting reagent. Okay. Hydrogen is going to be our limiting reagent. Now why does it become important? Well, it becomes important because we have actually already seen that. Because once we have determined that hydrogen is going to be our limiting reagent, we know that as the reaction proceeds further, okay, both nitrogen and hydrogen is going to get consumed in order to form ammonia, right? But at the end, when reaction has finally completed, we know that we will be left with 0 moles of hydrogen. Alright, that is, hydrogen is going to be completely consumed, but we will have some quantity of nitrogen left and some quantity of ammonia, which is less than what we might have expected. That is why limiting reagent is quite crucial, because it determines Okay, limiting reagent determines how much quantity of other reactants are going to be consumed and how much quantity of the product is going to be formed. Thanks for watching Edupedia World videos.